I know a lot of people are waiting to hear your side of the story because there's lots of things going on in the press. Lots of things being said from different sides. You were in the pits last week. You obviously witnessed it. And I'm sure the Somerset fans are keen to know your version of events.
You know, we started 8-4 with 6 points down. Gate one was good. Charles had a bad race in the first one, so I decided to put Jason Doyle in. Then it just all kicked off. You know, it's really bad, and you know, swearing, and then I can't take that in. But anyway, I let it go because I thought heat in the moment stuff. Then I said to a barn out there, obviously he won the race, so you know, but you never know that. But you know what I mean. And then I was hoping he'd come and apologise to me and that. But and then. You know, because I need to team manager, you know, I made that decision, and then it just all kicked off, and then afterwards it kicked off again, and then obviously I just waited for him to apologise to me. I gave him Thursday, Friday, Saturday before I started talking to other riders, because I couldn't, if he wasn't going to come back in the team, then tonight all I would have had to do was a National League rider against Paul, and I needed to sort another rider out. All I wanted off of him was an apology. Even if he didn't mean it, he would be here tonight. And that's all I wanted off of him. You know what I mean? I'm his boss at the end of the day, and I'm the team manager. I've got to make decisions, and that's the decision I felt.
Okay, just to clarify then, so Charles has had a poor ride in his first ride. We were 6 points down, and to the new rule, we can put a tactical substitute in. So you were considering putting Jason Doyle in. To replace Charles, and I think you said to me earlier, Gary, that it would have been lane one, gate one, which was looking pretty good during that evening. So your Sharrett was putting in the world champion in gate one to replace Charles.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to do. Because obviously the aim is, it's a team, is to win all the home matches, pick up a few points away so we can make the playoffs this year. That's the aim of the team. And when you're 6 points down, you know, Charles was a good rider around here, you know, but I had Jason Doyle sitting there and he would have done the race, you know what I mean? But, you know, it's hard because I've helped Charles out financially and everything this year and all the time he's been here. And for him to turn around and the way he treated me like that, I can't take it because I'm the manager and you know, I have to make decisions. And if he kicks off like that and then the others kick off like that, well, there's no point in me being here, so I'm going to walk. You know what I mean? But
I suppose you've got to have certain boundaries as a team manager, don't you? You know, in most professions, ladies and gents, you know, arguably if managers are sworn at, then arguably they're sacked. And I suppose you have to take a hard line, Gary.
Well, yeah, all I wanted was for him to text me or whatever and just say, Gary, I'm very sorry what happened overnight. You know, I know it's adrenaline going and that's why I never say it. I even put him in Heat 15, so there's nothing against him because I felt that pairing of Wright and Doyle would give me the 3-all pass. So Wolverhampton got no points and we took all three, you know what I mean? It could be right at the end of the day. So you know, I've still put him out there, but all I wanted was a sorry, Gary, the way I treated you that night. You know what I mean? But it didn't come.
So, as we are now, Gary, is this never, I mean, if Charles, for instance, was to apologise to you now,
too late.
Would you take him back?
I don't know whether the rules would let me do it, but if the rules would do, but it's unfair, you only have riders I've signed tonight, I guess I can't say that at all.
Okay, ladies and gents, there you go. Gary being very honest and giving his side of the story. And please give him a round of applause, he's come out here to speak.